Professor De Caro, thank you for, first of all, thank you for coming here in the STORM meeting. Now we are approaching a crucial time because we have to start as a project to communicate, further to communicate, we have to start to disseminate. So we have to show something, our achievement and our result. So I know in your huge experience of many, many projects, an European one, an international one, which are your suggestion to, for us to do our job better in this environment of protection and safeguard of cultural heritage?
Probably you will have to act on different levels, in the sense that probably you will develop some practical tools and you develop philosophy or methodology of more general impact. We are an organization that has a mandate to disseminate good practice. So we have a library, we have a website, we have a series of publications, both digital and printed. So I would suggest that you you come in contact, in touch with our expert in communication, with our people, and to consider together which is the best way in order to touch the relevant people. Something is practical, and there can be pieces of knowledge to be translated in the language more needed. Something else, if it's like a philosophy, like a methodology, like guidelines, can be also produced together as a publication, or you can publish yourself and to disseminate to our network. It's a problem of just a little negotiation.
Thank you very much. This is very important for us. Just one more question.
Consider that our library is a library, a physical library, and is the most important library specialized in conservation of heritage, covering about more than 60 languages. So, and a lot of people comes to us in person through the website, searching material for conservation. And emergency now is becoming one of the most relevant issues for conservation. So we are a good partner for this.
The best community. Thank you very much. Just a small question, very quick, just to have your view. We are now with STORM, want to realize something, probably it's a research project, and so we are entitled also to make something which are not, it's not very common. We are want to start mobile smartphone, just to allow people accessing to cultural heritage site and to use these mobile questions, just to the question to give information. For example, we saw a truck, or we saw the security area, something.
We have used this kind of tools in some crisis areas like Nepal. For assessment and for management of post-assessment. Here, and we are also working on this in the Arab countries in a special project with the other organization, an assessment based on picture done by cell phone. The thing is to be managed is the risk of over flow of data, because it's very easy to have 1 million data from, especially if you have sites like Pompeii, you can be covered with data and people, and after it's difficult to deal with 1,000 pictures of the same kind. So you have to be careful in managing the management of the data, but it's good both for having information on some remote spots, which are not the most common, but where people go during the travels and so on, and for communication. People using the crowd information is always bad. They are passionate, and you have to sustain this interest in safe communication. So it's on one side useful in a practical way. On the other side, it's useful on the emotional way, keeping the people near the heritage.
Thank you very much. We will use your experience and all the US on that for sure. Thank you very much.